chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some.
For almost 40 years now, I've had the privilege of reading The Night Before Christmas to my children and grandchildren, and tonight will be no exception. This will be another fun evening of reading Mr. Clement Moore's very fine story, The Night Before Christmas. Our book lists December 1822 as the year the story evidently was written. And it was on a cold Wednesday that Christmas fell. Christmas Eve was on the Tuesday on the 24th. So that's the night we're talking about now. It was the night before Christmas when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes of St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plum danced in their heads, and Mom in her kerchief and I my cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there rose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the windows I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of a new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday to the objects below, when what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles his courses they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer, and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky, so up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkle I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes how they twinkled, his dimples how merry, his cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all his stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying a finger aside of his nose and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose. He sprang to a sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down on a thistle. But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night. And I'd like to wish my family a merry, merry Christmas this year and for all the years to come. A blessed Merry Christmas. Good night."
Tiny little tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. So I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Though it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.